Good evening. It's 9 p.m. here in Seoul. Thank you for joining us on Arirang News. We begin with President Yoon Suk-yeol's press conference earlier today, marking the two-year anniversary of his inauguration. Beginning with a 22-minute opening address followed by a Q&A session lasting more than 70 minutes, he reflected on his past 2 years while providing his vision for the next three. He also faced tough questions himself. Our presidential correspondent Kim Do-yeon starts us off.
The very first message from President Yoon Suk-yeol as the public tuned in on Thursday to his first press conference in 21 months was that he was sorry for coming up short in improving people's lives over the past 2 years. And with the decision to face the media coming after he vowed to enhance communication following the ruling People Power Party's losses in the general election, he called for cooperation at the opposition-led National Assembly.
국민 여러분, 정부가 민생을 위해 일을 더 잘하려면 국회의 협력이 반드시 필요합니다. 앞으로 여야 정당과 소통을 늘리고 민생 분야 협업도 더욱 강화하겠습니다. 국회에도 당부 말씀을 드립니다. 정쟁을 멈추고 민생을 위해 정부와 여야가 함께 일하라는 것이 민심이라고 생각합니다.
He answered the two most anticipated questions himself during the Q&A session that followed, but without a change in stance that his aides had previously reflected. But for the first time, President Yoon apologized for what he called his wife's unwise actions, referring to her accepting a luxury bag back in 2022, but he refrained from commenting about the recently opened investigation by the prosecution, saying any comments could be seen as influencing a fair investigation. Regarding the death of a young Marine who was swept away by flood water during a search and rescue mission following a flood last year, and allegations of the government interfering with an investigation into the incident, he hinted at vetoing the special probe bill passed by the Assembly, at least for now.
지금 이렇게 진행되는 것을 잘 지켜보고 아마 모든 절차가 마무리되면 또 국민 여러분께 수사 그 당국에서 아마 상세하게 그 수사 그 경과와 또 결과를 잘 설명을 할 것인데 그걸 보고 만약에 국민들께서 이거는 봐주기 의혹이 있다 납득이 안 된다라고 하시면은 그때는 제가 특검 하자고 먼저 주장을 하겠습니다.
There was also a surprising announcement. As he explained his next 3 years in office, he said he's seeking to create a new ministry to respond to the urgent issue of South Korea's low birth rate, with significant administrative power, or in his terms, aggressive policies, unlike now, when only consultative groups have been formed for this.
저출생 대응 기획부 장관이 사회 부총리를 맡도록 해서 교육, 노동, 복지를 아우르는 정책을 수립하고 단순히 복지 정책 차원을 넘어 국가 아젠다가 되도록 하겠습니다.
As for medical reform, with the doctors' collective action against the government plan to raise the medical school enrollment quota to tackle the nation's need for more doctors, he reiterated that the administration will push through while calling on doctors to come up with a combined opinion on the current process. 김도현, 아리랑 뉴스.